صباح الخير. تحية حارة باللغة العربية إلى جميع المؤمنين الحاضرين هنا اليوم في ساحة القديس بطرس، لا سيما المجموعات القادمة من مختلف الأبرشيات والرعايا والرهبانيات والهيئات والجماعات والحركات الكنسية. تحية خاصة إلى المؤمنين القادمين من جمهورية العراق، إلى المؤمنين القادمين من الجمهورية العربية السورية، إلى المؤمنين القادمين من الأرض المقدسة، إلى المؤمنين القادمين من جمهورية لبنان، إلى المؤمنين القادمين من المملكة الأردنية الهاشمية، إلى المؤمنين القادمين من جمهورية مصر العربية. بينما نستعد لاستقبال قداسة البابا فرانسيس، نذكركم أن البطاقات للمشاركة في اللقاءات العامة هي دائماً مجانية وتصدر حصرياً من إدارة شؤون البيت البابوي. علاوة على ذلك، نعلن أنه في نهاية المقابلة العامة سيكون ممكناً لمن يرغب المشاركة في القداس الإلهي للحجاج الذي يتم الاحتفال به في بازيليك القديس بطرس في الساعة 12 ظهراً. شكراً.
Witamy serdecznie pielgrzymów polskich. Oprócz rodzin i osób, które przybyły indywidualnie, są tu obecni pielgrzymi z diecezji włocławskiej, pielgrzymi z parafii świętej Katarzyny Aleksandryjskiej, dziewicy i męczennicy w Korczewie, funkcjonariusze i pracownicy Służby Więziennej Polskiej wraz z rodzinami, grupa osób z zespołem Downa ze Stowarzyszenia Niepełnosprawnych z Wołowa i Wrocławia wraz z opiekunami, pielgrzymi z parafii świętego Jana 23 w Komornikach, gimnazjum Sfatecho Franciszka w Lewoczi. Szczególnie witamy i pozdrawiamy pary nowożeńców. Przygotowując się na spotkanie z Ojcem Świętym, przypominamy, że bilety wstępu na audiencję są zawsze darmowe i wydawane wyłącznie przez prefekturę Domu Papieskiego. Ponadto informujemy, że po zakończeniu audiencji dla chętnych będzie możliwość uczestniczenia w mszy świętej dla pielgrzymów odprawianej w Bazylice Świętego Piotra o godzinie 12.
Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. And a warm welcome to all of you joining us here live in St. Peter's Square in the Vatican. Those of you, our television viewers, can see Pope Francis there in the Jeep going around the square. The audience is outside today in St. Peter's Square as it was last week with these beautiful days of September we're having. And luckily today it's not a rainy day. We've had some rain in recent days. Pope Francis is, as he often does, at just before the start of this Wednesday general audience, he visits the square and greets the pilgrims present there that we're seeing here on the live images. I'd like to offer a warm welcome to those broadcasters that link up with us in a special way, including the Catholic Faith Network in America, Shalom World Television, Salt and Light Television, EWTN Television, Atmar Darshan Television India, and Catholic TV. As well, we have some radio networks linking up with us directly here, and they include Luminous Radio India, Radio Maria Papua New Guinea, and Radio Maria England. There is, well, many other radio and television media outlets who are linking up with us or broadcasting deferred this live audience, depending on where you are in the world, or watching on demand. on our YouTube channel, Vatican News YouTube channel, or of course our Facebook Live feed, and as well on demand following the audience here. And once again, for our radio listeners, Pope Francis is continuing his tour, so to speak, around the square in the aisles, corridors that are set up, with all the crowds gathering at the edges of these corridors, moving away from their seats to get a to be able to greet the Pope up close. Occasionally, Pope Francis is taking a child in hand and blessing the child. He's waving, of course, seated in this jeep, and proceeding throughout the square there to greet those present. I would say many of them are quite lucky because the crowds are not too large today, at least not yet. There are still more people arriving. And so many are lucky enough to get a close-up view or a photo of Pope Francis as he proceeds through the square. I'll be providing you here, of course, with English translation of today's audience. And as traditionally happens at the audience, Pope Francis, we hear a readings that introduce in some ways the theme of today's audience, and the theme will be his continuing catechesis on the subject of discernment, the elements of discernment and familiarity with the Lord. The audience begins with the liturgical greeting, and this reading, first scripture reading first in Italian, followed by French, English, and German, and we'll hear as well Polish, Arabic, Portuguese, Spanish as well. The same reading in the various languages. And now Pope Francis is proceeding up to the area in front of St. Peter's Basilica, the raised area with the canopy covering that area, where he will be seated and begin this audience. But not before he's greeted the many people there who have even joined him inside the jeep there for the ride, and whom he's greeted warmly. Pope Francis had a quite busy schedule in recent days. On Saturday, he was in Assisi in Italy, on Saturday for the whole day, at the conclusion of what was a long-awaited event, bringing together young people for the international meeting of the Economy of Francesco, where he joined thousands of young people from around the world to talk about how to make a new world economy, bringing together young people who are studying economics or already graduated and looking at ways to make the economy a more humane world economy. So he brought together young economists, entrepreneurs, and change makers to commit themselves to making a difference in the world. Following Saturday, then, he went up to, or went down, that is, to the southern Italian city of Matera in the Basilicata region, where he joined the nation's bishops for their National Eucharistic Congress and its conclusion. That was also a half-day visit. And here we are now in St. Peter's Square. Pope Francis's vehicle there is just behind where he will be seated. He's heading to where he will be seated and begin the audience here in St. Peter's Square. For those of you just joining us, you're tuned into a live broadcast here of the Wednesday General Audience taking place here in St. Peter's Square. Our television viewers are seeing here the panorama from above, from the colonnade just above the square, of those present, with more arriving in the square as we speak. Now Pope Francis is proceeding to his chair and will mark the beginning of this audience.
Il Santo Padre dà ora inizio all'udienza generale introducendola con il segno della croce e il saluto liturgico. Disponiamoci ad accogliere la sua
parola. And we'll begin the audience with the sign of the cross and the liturgical greeting. Let us dispose ourselves to welcome this.
In nome del Padre, del Figlio e dello Spirito Santo. La pace sia con voi.
Dalla lettera di San Paolo Apostolo agli Efesini. Fratelli, fate molta attenzione al vostro modo di vivere, comportandovi non da stolti ma da saggi. Non siate perciò sconsiderati, ma sappiate comprendere qual è la volontà del Signore. Siate ricolmi dello Spirito, intrattenendovi fra voi con salmi, inni, canti ispirati, rendendo continuamente grazie per ogni cosa a Dio Padre, nel nome del Signore nostro Gesù Cristo. È parola di Dio.
De la lettre de Saint Paul apôtre aux Éphésiens. Frères, prenez bien garde à votre conduite. Ne vivez pas comme des fous, mais comme des sages. Ne soyez donc pas insensés, mais comprenez bien quelle est la volonté du Seigneur. Soyez plutôt remplis de l'Esprit Saint. Dites entre vous des psaumes, des hymnes et des chants inspirés. À tout moment et pour toute chose, au nom de notre Seigneur Jésus-Christ, rendez grâce à Dieu le Père. Parole du Seigneur.
And now we'll hear this letter to the Ephesians. First heard in Italian and French. We will now hear it in English.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Be careful then how you live, not as unwise people, but as wise. Do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. Be filled with the Spirit as you sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs among yourselves, giving thanks to God the Father at all times and for everything, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Lesung aus dem Brief des Apostels Paulus an die Epheser. Brüder und Schwestern, achtet also sorgfältig darauf, wie ihr euer Leben führt, nicht wie Toren, sondern wie Kluge. Darum seid nicht unverständig, sondern begreift, was der Wille des Herrn ist. Lasst euch vom Geist erfüllen. Lasst in eurer Mitte Psalmen, Hymnen und geistliche Lieder erklingen, und sagt Gott, dem Vater, jederzeit Dank für alles im Namen unseres Herrn Jesus Christus. Wort des lebendigen Gottes.
And now we'll hear the reading in Spanish we just heard in German.
Lectura de la carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Efesios. Hermanos, cuiden mucho su conducta y no procedan como necios, sino como personas sensatas. No sean irresponsables, sino traten de saber cuál es la voluntad del Señor. Cuando se reúnan, reciten salmos, himnos y cantos espirituales, dando gracias siempre y por cualquier motivo a Dios, nuestro Padre, en nombre de nuestro Señor Jesucristo. Palabra de Dios.
And now we'll hear the reading in Portuguese, followed by Arabic and then Polish.
Leitura da carta de São Paulo aos Efésios. Irmãos, vede bem como procedeis, não como insensatos, mas como sensatos. Por isso mesmo, não vos torneis nécios, mas tratai de compreender qual é a vontade do Senhor. Deixai-vos encher do Espírito. Entre vós, cantais salmos, hinos e cânticos espirituais, sem cessar. Dai graças por tudo a Deus Pai, em nome de nosso Senhor Jesus Cristo. Palavra do Senhor.
قراءة من رسالة القديس بولس الرسول إلى أهل أفسس. أيها الإخوة، تبصروا إذن تبصراً حسناً في سيرتكم، فلا تسيروا سيرة الجهلاء بل سيرة العقلاء، فإياكم أن تكونوا من الأغبياء، بل افهموا ما هي مشيئة الرب. دعوا الروح يملأكم واتلوا معاً مزامير وتسابيح وأناشيد روحية، واشكروا الله الآب كل حين على كل شيء باسم ربنا يسوع المسيح. كلام الرب.
And finally now Polish.
Czytanie z listu świętego Pawła Apostoła do Efezjan. Bracia, baczcie więc pilnie, jak postępujecie. Nie jak niemądrzy, ale jak mądrzy. Nie bądźcie przeto nierozsądni, lecz usiłujcie zrozumieć, co jest wolą Pana. Napełniajcie się Duchem, przemawiając do siebie wzajemnie psalmami i hymnami i pieśniami pełnymi ducha. Dziękujcie zawsze za wszystko Bogu Ojcu w imię Pana naszego Jezusa Chrystusa. Oto Słowo Boże.
And after that, reading from the letter to the Ephesians, we, in the various languages, will now hear at the Pope's catechesis on discernment, which he will read in Italian, and followed by summaries also in the same languages.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, good morning.
Riprendiamo le catechesi.
We resume our catechesis on the theme of discernment.
Perché è molto importante il tema di discernimento per sapere cosa succede dentro di noi.
It's very important, this theme of discernment, to understand what's going on inside ourselves. You know, we need to understand where things are coming to us, ideas and thoughts, concerns. So today we will focus on the first of its constituent elements, which is prayer. To discern, we need to pray. Prayer is an indispensable aid for spiritual discernment, especially when it involves the affections, enabling us to address God with simplicity and familiarity, as one would speak to a friend. It's knowing how to go beyond thoughts, to enter into intimacy with the Lord, with an affectionate spontaneity. The secret of the lives of the saints is familiarity and confidence with God, which grows in them and makes it ever easier to recognize what's pleasing to Him. So prayer involves familiarity and confidence in God. It's not just a matter of repeating prayers repetitively. It's also this connection, this familiarity with God. This familiarity overcomes fear or doubt that His will is not for our good, a temptation that sometimes runs through our thoughts and makes the heart restless and uncertain and even bitter. Discernment does not claim absolute certainty. It's not like a chemically pure method. It doesn't claim absolute certainty, because it's about life. And life is not always logical. It has many aspects that cannot be enclosed in one type or category of thought. We'd like to know precisely what should be done. Yet even when it happens, we do not always act accordingly. How many times have we, too, had the experience described by the Apostle Paul, who says, "For I do not do the good I want, but the evil I do not want." We are not just reason. We're not machines. It's not enough to be given instructions to carry them out. The obstacles, like the helps and aids to deciding for the Lord, are primarily affective, from the heart. It's significant that the first miracle performed by Jesus in Mark's Gospel is an exorcism. In the synagogue of Capernaum, He delivers a man from the devil, freeing him from the false image of God that Satan has been suggesting since the beginning, that of a God who does not want our happiness. The possessed man in the Gospel here knows that Jesus is God, but this does not lead him to believe in Him. In fact, he says, "You've come to ruin us." Many people, even Christians, think the same thing. That is, that Jesus may well be the Son of God, but they doubt that He wants our happiness. Indeed, some fear that taking His proposal seriously, what Jesus proposes to us, means ruining our lives, mortifying our desires, our strongest aspirations. These thoughts sometimes creep up inside us, that God asks too much of us. We have fear, or wants to, or that He doesn't love us, and He wants to take away what we hold most dear. Instead, in our first encounter, we see that the sign of meeting the Lord is joy. When I pray to the Lord, I become joyous. It's a beautiful thing. Instead, sadness or fear, on the other hand, are signs of distancing from Him. If you would enter life, keep the commandments, Jesus says to the rich young man.
Fortunately for that young man, some obstacles did not allow him to implement the desire in his heart to follow the good teacher more closely. He was an interested, enterprising young man. He'd taken the initiative to meet Jesus, but he was also very divided in his affections. For him, riches were too important. Jesus does not force him to make up his mind, but the text notes that the young man turns away from Jesus sad. Those who turn away from the Lord are never happy, even though they have an abundance of possessions and possibilities at their disposal. Jesus never forces us to follow him. He lets us know his will for us. With a great heart, he tells us things. But he leaves us free. And this is the very beautiful thing about prayer and the freedom that Jesus gives us. But whenever we turn from the Lord, we're sad. It's bad for the heart. So discerning is not easy, for appearances are deceptive, but familiarity with God can melt doubts and fears in a gentle way, making our lives increasingly receptive to His gentle light, according to the beautiful expression of Saint John Henry Newman. The saints shine with reflected light and show in the simple gestures of their day the loving presence of God, who makes the impossible possible. It's said that two spouses who've lived together for so long, loving each other, end up resembling each other. Something similar can be said about affective prayer. In a gradual but effective way, it makes us more and more able to recognize what counts through connaturality as something that springs from the depths of our being. So, praying is not just about saying many words. It's opening our heart to Jesus, to drawing close to Jesus, to allowing Jesus to enter into my heart. And there we can begin to discern if it's Jesus who's asking or if it's ourselves who want something. This process of discernment that's helped in prayer. Let us ask for this grace to live a relationship of friendship with the Lord, as a friend speaks to a friend. One time, I met an old religious brother. And he was the doormaster of a place where priests stay. And every time he went by the chapel and he saw the altar, he would say hello to the altar. He had this closeness with the Lord. He didn't go there just to say words, but he went there and greeted the altar as if Jesus were his close friend. This is the kind of relationship we need to have in our prayer. Closeness and affective with our heart. Relationship with Jesus. A smile, even a simple gesture. And so not just to think about saying words, but developing this heartful relationship with the Lord. And so we speak to the Lord like we would speak to a friend. It's a grace we must ask for one another, to see Jesus as our greatest and most faithful friend, someone who does not blackmail us or extort us, above all, who never abandons us, even when we turn away from Him. Jesus always stays with us, close to us, with His heart. He's always faithful to us and close to us. So let's keep this simple prayer of the idea of greeting the Lord and saying, "Hello, Lord." The prayer of closeness, few words, but with gestures and with good works, is a good help for us in our spiritual life. Pope Francis adding many other ad lib words to his catechesis today on discernment, encouraging a close relationship with the Lord, as with a friend. Now we're hearing the introduction on the part of the French-speaking faithful who warmly greet Pope Francis, and the reader is reading this to the Pope, and this will be followed now. She will read the summary of this catechesis we've just heard, a brief summary in French. The French speakers reminding everyone there that Pope Francis will give his apostolic blessing at the conclusion of the audience and bless the items they brought with them to be blessed, and in a special way to all those who are ill and those wishing for his blessing. And here is the summary in French now of the catechesis.
Une aide indispensable au discernement spirituel nous permettant de nous adresser à Dieu comme à un ami. Le secret de la vie des saints est la familiarité et la confiance en Dieu, car la familiarité vainc la peur ou le doute. Le discernement ne prétend pas à une certitude absolue, car il concerne la vie qui n'est pas toujours logique. Il est significatif que le premier miracle accompli par Jésus dans l'évangile de Marc soit un exorcisme qui libère l'homme d'une fausse image de Dieu qui ne voudrait pas notre bonheur. Beaucoup de personnes, des chrétiens aussi, pensent la même chose. Jésus est peut-être fils de Dieu, mais il doute qu'il veuille notre félicité. Le signe de la rencontre avec le Seigneur est la joie, alors que la tristesse ou la peur sont des signes qui nous éloignent de lui. Celui qui s'éloigne du Seigneur n'est jamais content, même s'il est à l'abri du besoin. Discerner n'est pas une chose facile, car les apparences sont trompeuses, mais la familiarité avec Dieu peut dissiper les doutes et les craintes en rendant notre vie toujours plus réceptive à sa douce lumière. Les saints brillent d'une lumière réfléchie et montrent dans les simples gestes de leur journée la présence aimante de Dieu qui rend possible l'impossible. La prière, de manière graduelle mais efficace, nous rend de plus en plus capables de reconnaître ce qui est essentiel, ce qui jaillit du fond de notre être. Et maintenant, le Saint-Père va saluer en italien des francophones.
Saluto cordialmente i pellegrini di lingua francese, in particolare i capi di istituto dell'insegnamento cattolico di Pontoise, come il signor Stanislas Lalanne. Fratelli e sorelle, chiediamo la grazia di vivere una relazione di amicizia con il Signore, la grazia di vedere Gesù come il nostro amico più grande e fedele, che ci accompagna anche nei momenti difficile della nostra vita. Dio vi benedica.
Pope Francis greeting the French-speaking pilgrims in Italian there, and that what he said is now being translated into French. I cordially greet the French-speaking pilgrims, in particular the heads of the Catholic Teaching Institute of Pontoise, led here by Bishop Stanislas Lalanne. Brothers and sisters, we ask for the grace to live a relationship of friendship with the Lord, the grace to see Jesus as our greatest and most faithful friend who accompanies us even in the difficult moments of our lives. God bless you all.
Dans les moments difficiles de notre vie, que Dieu vous bénisse.
And now we will hear in English the summary of the catechesis and the greetings of the English-speaking faithful shared there with Pope Francis.
Most Holy Father, the English-speaking pilgrims and visitors wish to express to you their sentiments of deep respect and esteem and to assure you of their prayers for your ministry as the successor of Saint Peter. At the end of the audience, we will sing together the Our Father in Latin. His Holiness will then impart his apostolic blessing, which he extends in a particular way to the members of your families at home. He also intends to bless any religious articles you may have brought for this purpose. And in a special way, his blessing goes to your children, the elderly, and those who are sick. The following is a summary of the Holy Father's catechesis at the beginning of the audience. Dear brothers and sisters, in our continuing catechesis on discernment, the process of making sound decisions about the God-given meaning and direction of our lives, we now consider the importance of prayer. Praying is never a purely intellectual exercise. It also engages the heart and the emotions. Through prayer, we deepen our friendship with the Lord. We grow in trust as we realize that in coming to understand and embrace His holy will, we find our true happiness. One of the great temptations in the spiritual life is the fear that fidelity to God's will can make us sad or unfulfilled. Prayer helps us to overcome such empty fears and brings instead a deep spiritual joy, even in the midst of trials and tribulations. As the fruit of prayer, discernment makes us sensitive to God's kindly light, illuminating our minds and warming our hearts. Drawing each day closer to the Lord, we come by a certain connaturality to recognize more fully His will for our lives, and in that will to find our peace and our authentic fulfillment. The Holy Father will now greet us in Italian.
Do il benvenuto a tutti i pellegrini di lingua inglese presenti all'odierna udienza, specialmente a quelli provenienti da Danimarca, Ghana, Filippine, Canada e Stati Uniti. Rivolgo un saluto cordiale ai numerosi gruppi di giovani studenti e in particolare ai candidati al diaconato del Pontificio Collegio Americano del Nord, insieme con le loro famiglie. Su tutti voi invoco la gioia e la pace di Cristo nostro Signore. Dio vi benedica.
I greet the English-speaking pilgrims taking part in today's audience, especially those from Denmark, Ghana, the Philippines, Canada, and the United States of America. I offer a cordial greeting to the numerous students groups present, and in particular the diaconate class of the Pontifical North American College and their families. Upon all of you, I invoke the joy and peace of our Lord. God bless you.
And now we will hear the greetings on the part of the German-speaking pilgrims there to Pope Francis and a summary of the catechesis there.
Heiliger Vater, die Gläubigen deutscher Sprache möchten Ihnen ihre herzliche Zuneigung und aufrichtige Verbundenheit bekunden und versichern Sie zugleich Ihres Gebets in allen Anliegen Ihres universalen apostolischen Dienstes. Zum Schluss dieser Audienz singen wir gemeinsam das Vaterunser in lateinischer Sprache. Danach wird der Heilige Vater den apostolischen Segen erteilen. Gern schließt er darin ihre Angehörigen ein, besonders die Kinder, die älteren Menschen und die Leidenden. Er segnet auch die Rosenkränze und die übrigen Andachtsgegenstände, die sie dafür mitgebracht haben. Es folgt nun eine Zusammenfassung der Katechese des Heiligen Vaters,
in deutscher Sprache. Liebe Brüder und Schwestern, heute möchte ich auf ein wesentliches Moment einer guten Unterscheidung der Geister zu sprechen kommen, auf das Gebet, das es uns ermöglicht, ganz einfach und vertrauensvoll zu Gott zu sprechen, so wie mit einem Freund. Die familiäre Vertrautheit mit Gott, die das Leben aller Heiligen kennzeichnet, macht es mit der Zeit immer leichter zu erkennen, was Gott wohlgefällig ist und wirklich unserem Heil dient. Zugleich hilft eine persönliche Beziehung mit Gott auch gegen die immer wieder aufkommenden Zweifel. Gottes Wille sei vielleicht nicht zu unserem Besten, Gott meinte es mit uns eventuell gar nicht gut und hindere uns an einem glücklichen und erfüllten Leben. Aber so ist es nicht. Eine wirkliche Begegnung mit dem Herrn erkennt man gerade an der tiefen, anhaltenden Freude, die sie mit sich bringt. Traurigkeit oder Angst hingegen sind Zeichen der Gottferne. Von dem reichen Jüngling, der Jesus nachfolgen wollte, dies aber nicht schaffte, weil er zugleich an seinem großen Reichtum festhalten wollte, heißt es im Evangelium, dass er traurig wegging. Wer vom Herrn weggeht, wird nicht glücklich, auch wenn er noch so viel besitzt. Die Unterscheidung ist nicht leicht, denn der Schein kann trügen. Aber die Vertrautheit mit Gott kann Zweifel und Ängste sanft zerstreuen und unser Leben immer empfänglicher machen für sein mildes Licht. Der Heilige Vater richtet nun einen kurzen Gruß auf Italienisch an die deutschsprachigen Gläubigen.
Saluto cordialmente i fratelli e le sorelle di lingua tedesca, particolari i tanti scolari con i loro insegnanti oggi qui presenti. Chiediamo la grazia di vivere l'amicizia con il Signore, che si ricolma di quella gioia profonda che tutti cerchiamo. Egli non ci abbandona mai. Con lui non siamo mai soli.
Pope Francis just saying, I cordially greet our German-speaking brothers and sisters, especially the many school children and their teachers present here today. We ask for the grace to experience friendship with the Lord, who fills us with the deep joy we all seek. He never abandons us, and with him we are never alone.
Der uns mit jener tiefen Freude erfüllt, nach der wir uns alle sehnen. Verlässt uns nie, mit ihm sind wir nie allein.
And now we'll hear the greetings to Pope Francis on behalf of the Spanish-speaking pilgrims, and then Pope Francis will read the summary of his catechesis in Spanish himself.
Deseamos manifestarle cordialmente nuestros sentimientos de filial afecto que acompañamos con fervientes oraciones por sus intenciones como pastor de toda la Iglesia. Al final de este encuentro se cantará el Padre Nuestro en latín. Después, el Papa Francisco impartirá a todos los presentes la bendición apostólica que extiende complacido a sus familiares, especialmente a los niños y a los ancianos, a los enfermos y a cuantos sufren. Bendice también los rosarios y objetos de devoción que los peregrinos llevan consigo.
Queridos hermanos y hermanas, en esta catequesis sobre el discernimiento reflexionamos acerca de uno de los elementos constitutivos del discernimiento, que es la oración. La oración es indispensable para el discernimiento espiritual porque nos permite entrar en intimidad con el Señor, ser sus amigos y así poder reconocer lo que a Él le agrada. Esta relación íntima o relación familiar con Dios también nos ayuda a alejar los miedos y las dudas que pueden turbar nuestro corazón cuando nos disponemos a cumplir su voluntad. Sabemos que discernir no es fácil, porque no somos máquinas que reciben instrucciones y las llevan a cabo, sino personas En la vida de las personas muchas veces se presentan tantos tipos de obstáculos, sobre todo afectivos. Lo vemos en el caso del joven rico que quería seguir a Jesús, pero tenía su corazón dividido entre él y las riquezas. Al final optó por las riquezas, aunque esto lo dejara triste. Por eso es necesario ser amigos de Jesús, estar abiertos a su gracia, para que Él nos ayude a superar las dificultades y a seguirlo con alegría. Saludo cordialmente a los peregrinos de lengua española.
I cordially greet the Spanish-speaking pilgrims. Let us ask Jesus to teach us to pray with simplicity and familiarity, as a friend speaks to a friend. He's the faithful friend who never fails, who always comes to meet us, even when we turn away from Him. God bless you all. And may Our Lady accompany you. Thank you very much. And now we're going to hear the Portuguese greetings and summary of the catechesis.
Desejam testemunhar-lhe filial afeto e sincera fidelidade, e rezam por todas as intenções do seu ministério apostólico universal. No final da audiência, cantaremos a oração do Pai Nosso em latim. Depois, o Santo Padre concederá a bênção apostólica com um pensamento especial às crianças, aos idosos e aos doentes. Abençoará também os terços e demais objetos de devoção que cada um tiver consigo. Leia agora um resumo da catequese que o Santo Padre acaba de pronunciar. O primeiro dos elementos constitutivos do discernimento é a oração. Falo de uma oração rica de afeto que nos permite falar com Deus como quem fala com um amigo. Efetivamente, discernir e decidir fazer o que agrada a Deus é exigente, mas os santos faziam-no com naturalidade. Conseguiam agir deste modo porque, através da oração, alimentavam a amizade com Deus e, pouco a pouco, tornavam-se capazes de distinguir o mais importante. É verdade, o segredo da vida dos santos está precisamente nessa sua familiaridade com Deus na oração, com a qual venciam as tentações que nos levam a desconfiar de Deus, pensando que Ele nos está a pedir demasiado, ou nos quer tirar o que mais gostamos. Como nos mostra o caso do jovem rico no Evangelho, ele tomou a iniciativa de encontrar-se com Jesus, mas não o aceita o convite para o seguir, porque, preso às riquezas que tinha, não as quis deixar. E retirou-se triste. Discernir não é fácil, porque as aparências enganam, mas a familiaridade com Deus pode dissolver suavemente dúvidas e receios e tornar-nos cada vez mais capazes de reconhecer aquilo que conta, quase por conaturalidade, como uma coisa que brota do mais fundo do nosso ser. Agora o Santo Padre saúda em italiano os fiéis de língua portuguesa.
Saluto i pellegrini di lingua portoghese, in particolare i gruppi brasiliani di Iataccino e Sorocaba, il centro di Apollo e riabilitazione per persone con deficienza della Santa Casa di Misericordia di Villa do Conde, sito a Tunghigna e qui rappresentato soprattutto dai più giovani venuti a ringraziare Dio per lo scampato pericolo del Covid. Cari amici, guardate sempre avanti e non lasciate che il passato condizioni la vostra vita. Lavorate per ottenere le cose che desiderate. Insieme a voi e ai vostri cari, chiedo alla Beata Vergine Maria che si prenda cura in tutte, di tutti voi e vi protegga. Dio vi benedica.
Pope Francis just saying, I greet the Portuguese-speaking pilgrims. This is now being translated into Portuguese. In particular, the Brazilian groups from Jatadzinho and Sorocaba, and those from the Rehabilitation Center of the Santa Casa de Misericordia de Vila de Conde, located in Tuyinha, Brazil, and represented here by the young people who've come to thank God for coming out of the COVID pandemic. He says, dear friends, always look forward and do not let the past condition your life. Work to achieve the things you desire, and together with you and your loved ones, I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary to take care of all of you and to protect you. God bless you all.
Trabalhai para conseguirdes as coisas que desejais, juntamente convosco e os vossos entes queridos. Peço à bem-aventurada Virgem Maria que cuide de todos e vos proteja. Deus vos abençoe.
And now we will hear the greetings of the Arabic-speaking faithful and a summary of the catechesis in Arabic.
أيها الأب الأقدس، يسر المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية الحاضرين هنا أن يعبروا لكم عن مشاعر الاحترام والتقدير وشكرهم البنوي ويرفقونها بصلواتهم الدائمة إلى الله من أجل قداستكم وخدمتكم كخليفة القديس بطرس. في نهاية هذه المقابلة سنرتل معا صلاة الأبانا باللغة اللاتينية، ثم سيمنح الأب الأقدس جميع الحاضرين البركة الرسولية ويشمل بها جميع أحبائكم وخاصة الأطفال والمتزوجين حديثا والمسنين والمرضى والمتألمين بآلام شديدة، وسيبارك كذلك المسابح والأشياء الطقوية التي يحملها معه كل واحد منكم. إليكم ملخص التعليم المسيحي لقداسة البابا فرانسيس. تكلم قداسة البابا اليوم على العنصر الأول من عناصر التمييز وهو الصلاة، وقال: الصلاة هي عنصر مساعد لا غنى عنه من أجل التمييز الروحي، وخاصة عندما تمتلئ الصلاة بالمشاعر وتجعلنا نتوجه إلى الله ببساطة وألفة، كما لو أننا نتحدث إلى صديق. الصلاة هي أن نعرف كيف نتجاوز أفكارنا وندخل في صلة حميمة مع الرب يسوع، فالإلفة معه تساعدنا على أن نتغلب على الخوف أو على الشك في أن إرادته ليست من أجل خيرنا، وهي تجربة تراودنا أحياناً وتجعل قلبنا قلقاً ومتردداً. يعلم المسيحيون أن يسوع هو ابن الله، لكن البعض منهم يشك أحياناً في أنه يريد سعادتنا، بل يخشون أن ساروا معه جدياً أن تدمر حياتهم، فيجب كبح رغباتهم وتطلعاتهم والابتعاد عن كل عزيز عليهم. لكن رأينا في لقائنا الأول في موضوع التمييز إن علامة اللقاء مع الرب يسوع هي الفرح، بينما الحزن والخوف هما من علامات البعد عنه. من يبتعد عن الرب يسوع لن يكون سعيداً أبداً، حتى لو كان يملك خيرات وإمكانيات كثيرة. التمييز ليس سهلاً لأن المظاهر تخدعنا، بينما الإلفة مع الله يمكن أن تبدد شكوكنا ومخاوفنا وتجعلنا قادرين على أن نميز بطريقة فعالة. لذلك الصلاة المليئة بالمشاعر تساعدنا على التمييز وتجعلنا أكثر قدرة على معرفة ما هو مهم لحياتنا وما هو سبب فرحنا. والآن تحية البابا باللغة الإيطالية لأبناء الشرق الناطقين باللغة العربية.
Saluto i fedeli di lingua araba. Viviamo una relazione di amicizia con il Signore, perché Egli è il nostro amico più grande e fedele, che non ricatta, soprattutto che non ci abbandona mai, anche quando noi ci allontaniamo da Lui. Il Signore vi benedica tutti e vi protegga sempre da ogni male.
Pope Francis saying in Italian, now to be translated into Arabic, I greet the Arabic-speaking faithful. Let us live a relationship of friendship with the Lord, for He is our greatest and most faithful friend, who does not blackmail, above all, who never abandons us, even when we turn away from Him. May the Lord bless you all and protect you always from all evil. And we just heard the Arabic greetings, or the greetings of the Arabic-speaking faithful to Pope Francis. Before that, the summary of the catechesis, and now we will hear the same here coming up in Polish.
Ojcze Święty, pielgrzymi z Polski i z innych krajów pragną przekazać Waszej świątobliwości wyrazy synowskiego oddania i szczerej wierności, zapewniając o modlitwie we wszystkich intencjach Jego apostolskiej posługi. Na zakończenie audiencji zaśpiewamy modlitwę Ojcze Nasz po łacinie. Po jej zakończeniu Ojciec Święty udzieli apostolskiego błogosławieństwa, obejmując z nim szczególnie dzieci, osoby w podeszłym wieku i dotknięte cierpieniem. Pobłogosławi także różańce i dewocjonalia, jakie pielgrzymi przynoszą ze sobą. Oto streszczenie katechezy Ojca Świętego. W dalszych rozważaniach na temat rozeznania dziś skupimy się na modlitwie, która jest jego istotnym elementem i pomocą. Pozwala zwracać się do Boga z prostotą i zaufaniem, tak jak mówi się do przyjaciela. Przez nią wchodzimy w zażyłą więź z Panem, dzięki której można pokonać lęk i wątpliwości co do Jego woli oraz rozpoznać, co jest Jemu miłe. Rozeznanie nie wymaga absolutnej pewności, ponieważ dotyczy życia, a w życiu jest wiele aspektów, których nie da się zamknąć w jednej kategorii myślowej. Chcielibyśmy dokładnie wiedzieć, co należy robić, ale nawet gdy tak jest, nie zawsze postępujemy konsekwentnie. Sami doświadczyliśmy niejednokrotnie tego, o czym pisze apostoł Paweł w liście do Rzymian. Nie czynię dobra, którego chcę, ale czynię właśnie zło, którego nie chcę. Wielu ludzi, również chrześcijan, wątpi, czy Bóg chce naszego szczęścia. Niektórzy obawiają się, że poważne potraktowanie Jego propozycji oznaczałoby zrujnowanie naszego życia, stłumienie naszych pragnień, aspiracji. Czasami nachodzą nas myśli, że Bóg wymaga od nas zbyt wiele. Tymczasem znakiem spotkania z Panem jest radość, a smutek czy lęk to znaki oddalenia się od Niego. Rozeznanie nie jest łatwe, bo pozory mylą. Jednak modlitwa stopniowo, ale skutecznie sprawia, że stajemy się coraz bardziej zdolni do rozpoznania tego, co się liczy. Prośmy o łaskę trwania w zażyłej relacji z Panem, abyśmy widzieli w Nim naszego najwierniejszego przyjaciela. Teraz Ojciec Święty pozdrowi nas, Polaków, w języku włoskim.
Saluto cordialmente i Polacchi, in particolare i dirigenti, i funzionari e i capellani del servizio penitenziario venuti a Roma per ringraziare di aver ottenuto San Paolo come loro patrono. Fra qualche giorno inizia il mese di ottobre tradizionalmente dedicato alla Madonna del Rosario. Recitando questa preghiera nelle comunità e nelle famiglie, affidate a Maria le vostre preoccupazioni e bisogni nel mondo, soprattutto la questione della pace. Dio vi benedica.
Pope Francis saying, I cordially greet the Polish-speaking pilgrims, in particular the directors, officials, and chaplains of the prison outreach who've come to Rome to give thanks for having St. Paul as their patron. In a few days, the month of October will begin, and that's traditionally dedicated to Our Lady of the Rosary. By reciting the Rosary in your communities and families, entrust to Mary your worries and the needs of the world, especially that of peace. God bless you all.
Zawierzajcie Maryi wasze troski i potrzeby świata, zwłaszcza sprawę pokoju. Niech Bóg wam błogosławi.
And finally we'll hear the greetings of the Italian-speaking faithful there to Pope Francis, followed by Pope's greetings as well to them.
Santo Padre, i fedeli di lingua italiana desiderano esprimerle filiale affetto e sincera fedeltà e pregano per le intenzioni del suo universale ministero apostolico. A conclusione di questa udienza canteremo la preghiera del Padre Nostro in latino, terminata la quale il Santo Padre impartirà la benedizione apostolica che estende in modo speciale ai bambini, agli anziani e ai sofferenti. Benedirà anche i rosari e gli oggetti di devozione che ciascuno porta con sé.
Rivolgo un cordiale benvenuto ai pellegrini
italiani. And I extend a cordial greeting to the Italian-speaking pilgrims, in particular the faithful of Parete and Battipaglia, hoping that with the commitment of all, the religious zeal of their respective parish communities will grow. And finally, I'm thinking of the martyred Ukraine, which is suffering so much. The poor people there, so cruelly tried today, this morning. I spoke to Cardinal Krajewski, Conrad Krajewski, who just returned from Ukraine, who told me terrible things. Let's remember Ukraine and let's pray for this martyred people there. And then, of course, my thoughts go as usual to the young, the sick, the elderly, and newlyweds. May the Feast of the Archangels Michael, Gabriel, and Raphael, which we will celebrate tomorrow, inspire in all of us an authentic desire and following of the divine plans. May you recognize and follow the Lord who speaks in the secret of your conscience and your inner conscience. And I'd like to thank the Vatican Gendarmerie and celebrate their patron tomorrow as well. And they always follow the example of the archangels. And may the Lord bless them and watch out for them and all the good work that they do. To all of you, my blessing now.
Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum
Domino Hoviscum, sin nomine Domini Benedictum, aiuterium nostrum in nomine Domini, benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
And then applause following Pope Francis' apostolic blessing there, going out to all those present, all of you out there as well. Right now, Pope Francis is just greeting some of those present, many bishops, church leaders, and religious and lay people there, lining up just to shake hands and give him their greeting. Thank you all for joining us here live in St. Peter's Square for the Pope's weekly general audience. We invite you to join us again for our upcoming broadcast, including, of course, Sunday, 12 p.m., The Angelus, live from St. Peter's Square. You'll find more information on today's audience and all other events and celebrations happening here on vaticannews.va and links to our Facebook page, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube accounts are all there as well. On behalf of Vatican Media, all my colleagues and the technicians who've made this broadcast possible, I'd like to thank you as well for joining us. Laudetur Jesus Christus, praised be Jesus Christ.